Let's present the unique feature of the OSC oscilloscope to use expansion modules. Besides the two analog channels, there is also a multifunctional extension port. This port is based on the DE15 connector. As we can see from the specification, it has low voltage power lines like plus and minus 5 volts and 3.3 volts, one reference signal, one analog input, and several digital input-output lines. This interface is managed by an open protocol, so that the customer can make their own DIY modules like this one. This module can be connected to the oscilloscope in this way and be directly used. Later we will explain some possible applications for DIY modules. In alternative, it is possible also to purchase third-party modules. These modules are not expensive and allow the user to have new functionalities together with the oscilloscope. For example, this is an external trigger module, so with these modules it is possible to command the data acquisition with an external signal. With this module, this oscilloscope now can be triggered from channel A, or it can be triggered with an external signal. This other module is a signal generator. It can generate frequencies from 0 to 13 MHz. It can generate square waves, triangle waves, and sine waves. The amplitude can go from 0 to 4 volts. When we mount it, it is possible to have a quite compact device, which is an oscilloscope plus a signal generator. By connecting this module directly to the oscilloscope, we can see that the channel 2 is covered by the module. But actually this module have two BNC connectors. One is the output signal and the other BNC connector is the input line for the channel 2 that we are going to pass to the oscilloscope through the interface. In alternative, it is possible to use an extension cable to connect our modules. With the extension cable, we are free to use the BNC connector of the second channel. Then this module is a logic analyzer. When we connect it, the result is quite compact. It has four channels, and these four channels are synchronized with the analog channel A. It includes also a line with a reference signal. The protocol for this interface is open source, so the customer can make his own DIY modules or can purchase third-party modules, so to expand the capabilities of this oscilloscope. These modules are not expensive, but they can add a simple function to the oscilloscope. For example, the user can make their own module to measure electric current, or they can make modules that can take measurement data from sensors. So this is more or less the capabilities of this oscilloscope with the extension port. Let's see in detail the signal generator module. We connect the channel A of the oscilloscope to the output of the signal generator. We can already see on the software the wave generated by the signal generator. On the oscilloscope software, it's possible to open another panel with the settings for the signal generator. On this panel, we can change the shape of the generated wave. Now it is a triangle wave. We can change it to sine wave, or we can change it to a square wave. On this panel, we can change also the frequency. Now it's 1 kHz. Let's change it to 10 kHz. Here is our wave with 10 kHz frequency. We can also come back to the oscilloscope control panel to adjust the time division. Now we have a 10 kHz frequency and the amplitude, let's check, it's about 1.2 volts. We can change this amplitude with the first knob on the device. The amplitude can go from 0 to 4 volts. The second knob allows us to change the DC component of the wave. So with this second knob we can shift the wave up and down. For the generated frequency we can change it on the software interface. So we can change the amplitude with the first knob and the offset with the second knob. So this signal generator module is connected and controlled by the oscilloscope original software. This is the logic analyzer module. This module is called AL01 and it provides 4 inputs digital channels. Together with these channels we have also a reference signal that is generated by the oscilloscope. This signal is a square wave with frequency 1 kHz and we can use this to test the input of the logic analyzer. By connecting the analog channel of the oscilloscope to the reference signal, we can already see this signal on the software. We can see it is a 1 kHz signal. Now we can just connect the same reference signal to one digital input. As we can see in the software, the square wave appears on the black area below the analog channel. We can also add the other channels to the same reference signal. This is the second channel. Now we try to connect also the third channel. As we can see from the software, the same digital signal will appear on the other digital channels in the black area. Now we have 3 digital channels and 1 analog channel connected. We can connect also the last digital channel now. And we can see in the software that also the fourth channel appears. On the software, we can also activate or deactivate the black panel that shows the digital inputs. Now we can use the software to check the timing of this signal. By using a vertical cursor, we can see that all the channels are synchronized, including the analog channel.